Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and these are the top 10 hidden iPhone features to save time. What can iOS 14 do? A whole lot, actually. In fact, your iPhone is more powerful than ever. So let's jump into the top 10 hidden features to save time. So first up, let's start with a couple of iMessages features that are specific to the iOS 14 update. And number one is to at mention somebody in your chat. That's right, you can now tag a friend in your message. So here's what it looks like. Next time you're in a group chat and you want to direct message specifically to one member of that chat, just type the at symbol followed by their name, and then we'll hit space, and voila, their name starts to shine and then it turns blue so that they'll be tagged in your message. Second on the list when it comes to iMessages updates is reply directly to a specific message. So you know if you're talking about like three different things at the same time, but you want to reply to that first thing, well now you can thanks to iOS 14. Just tap and hold the message you want to reply to, and then select reply. So you'll type and send your message, and then just tap anywhere on your screen to close out of the reply thread. Now you've responded specifically to that thought. If you love these iOS 14 features and you want even more, I've got a video linked in the description below on some of the best iOS 14 features, and I'll put it again at the end of this video as well. But for now, number three on the list, add captions to photos and videos. This one is really handy if you like a little more context to your images or if you just want to save time by easily searching through your photos. So here's how to do it. Head to your photo album and select a photo or video, and then just swipe up on the image or video. Here, underneath, you have the option to add a caption. So I'll add a caption here. Now, when you want to find your specific images, you can do so from your library again by selecting the search button and then just type in those keywords. And look at that. How neat is that? Fourth on the list, improve Siri's pronunciation. Yeah, if you have a different name like me, Tasia, you may understand the pain of Siri never pronouncing your name right. Luckily, you can fix that by simply telling her, that's not how you pronounce that. So here's an example. I'll use my name. Hey Siri.
Hmm?
What's my name?
Your name is Tasia Custode, but you also go by Tasia.
Hey Siri.
Hmm?
That's not how you pronounce Tasia Custode.
Okay, let me hear how you say the name.
Tasia.
Okay, thank you. Which pronunciation is it okay for me to use?
So here I'm picking the pronunciation that I like best, and I'll go through the exact same process for my last name.
Tasia Custode. Tasia. Okay, let me hear how you say the name.
Custode.
Okay, thank you. Which pronunciation is it okay for me to use? Custode. Got it, it's Tasia Custode from now on.
By the way, this trick works on any of your contacts' names, addresses, anything that Siri might mispronounce. So, moving on to number five on the list. It's kind of a random one, but it's to use Backspace in your calculator app. I know, I told you it's random, but how many times have you been nearly done a calculation and you type in the wrong number? Well, all is not lost. Here's how to backspace just a number with one swipe. Swipe left or right over what you just typed. And look, each swipe removes a number from what was typed. So then you can just add in the proper number and finish your calculation where you left off. Woohoo! Talk about a time saver. Number six on the list is to undo typing or redo typing with just the shake of your wrist. I use the Notes app a ton on my iPhone, and this is a huge time saver. So here's how that works. Here we are in Notes, and I added a sentence that I don't really like. So with a simple shake of the wrist, boom, a pop-up appears and it's asking if I want to undo the typing. Now, what happens if you accidentally cut a big paragraph of text that you were just working on and you want it back? No worries, it's the exact same movement. So if we've just gotten rid of something that you typed, same trick works, shake my wrist, boom. A pop-up asks if I want to redo the typing. Heck yeah, I do. If you just missed a call from someone and want to quickly call them back with one touch, you can do that too. Number 7 on the list is to easily redial the last number that called you. So from your phone keypad, just tap on the green phone icon and your phone is gonna dial the last number that called you. No more digging around in your recents. Number 8 on the list is to master keyboard shortcuts. I know there's a ton of them, so specifically, I'm talking about stop toggling between your alphabetic keypad and your numeric keypad. You don't have to. Here's how. From your keyboard, just hold your finger on that 1, 2, 3 button in the bottom left here and drag it over the numbers or symbols you want and then let go. When you're done, you'll still be in your original keyboard. Amazing. Number 9 is one I've talked about before, and that's to hide unused apps rather than deleting them completely. If you've got an app you don't use too much, tap and hold down on that app icon to bring up the app's quick actions here. Then just tap remove app, then select move to app library. Now this is gonna move your app to the app library screen, which is after your last home page. It's still searchable and you'll still have it and its data there, but it's tucked away for safekeeping. I like to say it's like a winter sweater that you don't necessarily need all year, but it's tucked away for when it gets cold out. Okay, we have made it to number 10 on the list of iPhone features to save time, and that's to open up your apps quicker. Now there are a couple ways to search for and launch an app. Now, you can either search via your app library or using your search functionality by swiping down on your home screen. Not from the top, but about midway on the home screen. Swipe down. Now, as you type in the name of the app you want, your iPhone is going to put the most realistic answer right here up at the top. Now, notice how your keyboard at the bottom says go in the bottom right. Just hit go, boom. And that app is launched for you before you've even finished searching. It's kind of like Google Autocomplete, but for your app library. So remember, if you want to learn any other iOS 14 tricks, you can click up right here to watch that video, and I'll link to it again below. So those are my picks for the top 10 hidden iPhone features to save time. What do you think of these features, and what are your favorite features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more videos. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.